I am Rohit from Talent Battle and I welcome you all for this video lecture series for InfyTQ DBMS. Now today we will discuss about the lecture 2 that contains basic SQL. Now I hope that you have gone through the lecture 1 which was about database concept. If not, then just go through that lecture so it will be easy for you to understand the today's topic. For such material, we will be posting all this on our YouTube channel. So do not forget to subscribe the channel and also join our WhatsApp and Telegram group. The link is provided in the discussion box. So now we will discuss about the basic SQL. Introductory part to the SQL. So structured query language is a database query language used for storing and managing data in relational DBMS. SQL was the first commercial language introduced for relational model of database, and today almost all RDBMS such as your MySQL, Oracle, MS Access, they are using SQL as the standard database query language. SQL is used to perform all types of data operations in RDBMS. Right. Now discussing about the commands which comes under the category of SQL. So SQL defines different ways to manipulate the data which is stored in an RDBMS. The first one is DDL, Data Definition Language. It includes changes to the structure of the table like creation of table, altering the table or deleting a particular table and etc. All the DDL commands are auto-committed. It means that it will save all your changes permanently in the database, right? So this is important. Now if you check the commands, first is create. That will use to create a new table or new database. Alter command is for alteration. Truncate command is for deleting the data from table. Drop command is to drop a particular table. And rename is to rename a particular table. In the DML, that is data manipulation language, the DML commands are used for manipulating the data which is stored in the table and not the table itself. So the DML commands are not auto-committed. It means that changes that you are making are not permanent to the database. They can be rolled back. The commands comes under the category of DML are insert to insert a particular row, new row, update to update the existing row, delete to delete a particular row, and merge that will help you to merge two rows or two tables. Next one is TCL, that is transaction control language. These commands are to keep a check on other commands and their effect on the database. These commands can annul the changes made by other commands by rolling the data back to its original state. It can also make any temporary change permanent. The commands which are included in TCL are commit to permanently save the data, roll back to undo the changes, and the save point that will save for temporary basis. The DCL is another case, that is data control language, and the commands are grant and take back authority from any database user. There are two commands comes under the category of data control language. One is grant, that will grant the permission of particular operation or rights, and the revoke command is to take back the permissions. The data query language is used to fetch the data from tables based on the conditions that we can easily apply. So the command comes under the category of data query language is select. It will help you to retrieve the records from one or more table. Now we'll go with commands. First is create command, SQL create command. Now create is a DDL SQL command used to create a table or a database in relational database management system. Now to create a database in RDBMS, create command is used like this, and the syntax is follows: create database and the name of the database. For example, create database and test is the name of the database. So the above command will create a database named test, which will be an empty schema without any table. Now to create the tables in this newly created database, we can again use the create command for creating the tables. So for creating a table, create command can also be used. Now when we create a table, we have to specify the details of the columns of the tables too. we can specify the name and data types of various columns in the create command itself. If we check the syntax is like create table, then name of the table, and in the parentheses, you will give the different data types and the columns that consist in this particular table. So the create table command will tell the database system to create a new table with the given table name and the column information. For example, if you create a table called student and the information is like student ID with integer data type, name of the student for varchar and the size is 100 and age of the student again as an integer data type. So this command will create a new table with name student in the current database with three columns, namely student ID, name and age, where the column student ID will only store integer values, name will hold up to 100 characters and age will again store only integer value. If you are not currently logged into your database in which you want to create the table, then also you can add the database name along with the table name using a dot operator, right? For example, if you have a database with the name test and we want to create a table student, then we can utilize like create table test dot student, and the same remaining parameters will be as it is. Now, most commonly used data types for table columns are like this: integer, it is used for columns which will store the integer values. Float is used for columns which will store the float values. Double will be used for columns which will store the float values again. Varchar is used for columns which will be used to store characters and integers, basically a string. Char is used for columns which will store the character values, that is single character. Date is used for columns which will store the date values, and text is used for columns which will store the text, which is generally long in length. For example, if you create a table for storing profile information of a social networking website, then for about me section, you can have the column of type text because it consists of a very long length. Now next is our alter command in SQL. Alter command is used for altering the table structure, like to add a column to the existing table, to rename any existing table, to change the data type of any column or to modify its size, and to drop a column from the table. So the command syntax will be like this. Using alter command, we can add a column to an existing table. Say like alter table student and add, and in between parentheses, we will write down address varchar 200. So this command will add a new column address to the table student, which will hold the data of type varchar and which is nothing but actually the string of length 200. Now alter command can be used in various ways. Like first, alter command for adding multiple new columns. Using alter command, we can even add multiple new columns to any existing table. If you follow the syntax, you will come to know that if I want to add father name and mother name and date of birth, then I will use alter table student add father name varchar 60, mother name varchar 60 and date of birth date. So varchar 60 is the size for that respective parameter and date again is the data type for the DOB. So the above command will add three new columns to the student table. Another approach is like adding column with default values using alter command. So alter command can add a new column to an existing table with a default value too. The default value is used when no value is inserted in the column, and the syntax is like alter table student add date of birth date, default is 1st January 1999. So this above command will add a new column with the preset default value to the table student. Now for modifying an existing column using alter command, we can also be used to modify the data type of any existing column. For example, alter table student modify address varchar to 300. So we have changed the size and it will now hold up to 300 characters. Now alter command can be used to rename a column as well. So using alter command, you can rename an existing column. If you check the example, alter table student rename address to location. So this command will rename address column to location. For dropping a column using an alter command, it can also be used to remove the respective columns. If you check the example, alter table student and drop address. So this command will drop the address column from the table student. Now in SQL, another queries like truncate, drop or rename can also happen. So with the help of truncate command, it removes all the records from a table. But this command will not destroy the table structure. When we use truncate command on a table, it is auto incremented. Like primary key is also initialized. If you check the syntax, like truncate table student. So this query will delete all the records from the table student. Now in DML commands, we will study about the delete command, which is also more or less same as like truncate command. Okay. Now for drop command, it is completely removing a table from the database. This command will also destroy the table structure and the data which is stored in it. If you check the syntax, it will be like drop table and name of the table, that is student. So this query will delete the student table completely. It can also be used on the databases to delete the database, complete database, and the syntax will be like drop database and name of the database. For rename query, the rename command is used to set a new name for an existing table. If you check the syntax, for example, rename table student to students info. So this query will rename the current table student to students info. Now using the next insert command in terms of SQL category, data manipulation language statements, that is DML, are used for managing the data in database. DML commands are not auto-committed. It means that the changes made by DML command are not permanent to the database. It can be rolled back. Now considering the insert command, whenever we have a post on a tweet or a Twitter, the text is stored in some table and as a post, a new tweet, the new record gets inserted. So if you check the syntax of insert command, it is used to insert the data into a table. For example, consider a table student with the following fields like student ID, name and age. And now if you fire a query like insert into student and values will be 101, Adam and 15. So what this command will do? It will insert a new record into the student table like SID will be 101, name will be Adam and age will be 15. Now if you want to insert a value into a specific column, so we can use the insert command there as well to insert a values for only some specific columns of a row. So we can specify the name of the columns along with the values that to be inserted. For example, insert into student ID, comma name, values will be like 102 and Alex. So this query will give only insert into ID of student and name, and the newly inserted record will be added. If you want to insert a null value to a particular column, then the syntax will be like this: insert into student values 102, that is the ID, Alex, name of the student, and null. So this command will insert only two column values and the other column one value is set to null. So if you see the result, 102 ID, name is Alex, and the age is acting as a null value. Now if you want to insert a default value to a column, then the query will be like this: insert into student values 103, Chris, and default. So whatever the default value is set, that will be added. Suppose a column age in our table has a default value of 14. Now if you execute the query like insert into student values 103 comma Chris, the third parameter is not present, so it will take the default value of 14 and the output will be like this. Now using the update SQL command, let's take an example of a real world problem. So nowadays you are using Facebook and it provides an option for editing your status update. So in that case, you will be using an update SQL command. The syntax of this command is like update is used to update any record of data in a table. Like update table name and set column name equals to the new value where a particular sum condition is to be imposed. Now, where is used to add a condition to any SQL query? We will be working on this where clause as well in our next slides. So if you take the example of student sample table, where student ID, name and age is given, and if I apply the update query, so update student and set age equals to 18, where the student ID is 102. So what it will do, it will check the student ID 102 record and it will add 18 to the age column, right? Now you can use update for updating the multiple columns as well. So if you check the syntax, update student, set name equals to Abhi, age is 17, where SID is 103. So this command will update two columns of the record, which is having student ID as 103. So student ID 103, name will be Abhi and age will be 70. Now you can also utilize this update command for incrementing integer values. So when we have to update any integer value in a table, then we can fetch and update the value in the table in a single statement. For example, if we have to update the age column of student table every year for every student, then we can simply run the following statement of update to perform the following operation. Update student set age equals to age plus 1. So now what age equals to age plus 1 will do? It will increment the value of age by 1. Now make sure that this style will only work for integer values. Now using delete SQL command, when you ask for any information that needs to be deleted, then you will be using this DML command, that is delete DML command. So delete command is used to delete the data from a table. So for example, our general syntax will be like delete from table name. So if you have a student as an example for sample table, then it contains records like student ID, name and age. And when you delete this, so you can have like deleting all records from a table or deleting a particular record from a table. Now to delete all records from a table, you will be writing like delete from table name. So this command will delete all the records from the table student. And if you want to delete a particular record from a table, so in our student table, if you want to delete a single record, and we can use the where clause to check the condition, particularly for our delete statement. So my syntax will be like this: delete from table name, that is student, where my student ID is 103. So this command will delete the record where my student ID is 103 from the table student. Now the question arises, are delete is same as truncate? So truncate command is different from delete command. The delete command will delete all the rows from a table, whereas truncate command not only delete all the records stored in the table, but it also reinitializes the table like just like a newly created table. So for example, if you have a table with 10 rows and an auto increment primary key, so if you use the delete command to delete all the rows, it will delete all the rows but will not reinitialize the primary key. Hence, if you will insert any row after using the delete command, then using auto increment property of primary key, it will start from 11. But in case of truncate command, primary key will be reinitialized again and it will again start from 1. So moving further, for commit, rollback and save point SQL commands. Now for commit command, the transaction control language that commands are used to manage the transactions in the databases. So before starting with this, you must have gone through the DML and DDL commands. Now in commit command, it is used to permanently save any transaction into the database. So when we use any DML command like insert, update or delete, the changes made by these commands are not permanent until the current session is closed. The changes made by these commands can be rolled back. Now to avoid this, we are using the commit command to make the changes permanent. The syntax is only clear, you have to just write the commit keyword. Now in case of rollback, this command is going to restore the database to a last committed state. It is also used with save point command to jump to a particular save point in a current transaction. If you have to use the update command to make some changes into the database and realizing that those changes were not required, then what we can do, we can use the rollback command to roll back those changes, and if they were not committed, using the commit command. So if you check the syntax, it will be like rollback to particular save point. Now what save point is? A save point command is used to temporarily save a transaction so that you can roll back to that respective point. If you check the syntax, again it is very simple, save point and name of that save point. So you can say that using this command, we can name the different states of our data in any table and then roll back to that respective state using the rollback command whenever it is required. Now if you check the consideration of rollback, you will come to know the mapping of save point and rollback. Now for using grant and revoke operations, we have to consider the DCL, right? So data control language is used to control the privileges in databases. Now to perform any operation in the database, such as like for creating table, sequences or views, a user needs privileges. Privileges are of two types. First one is system, that will include the permission for creating session, table, etc. and all types of other system privileges. Whereas second one is object. It includes the permissions for any command or query to perform any operation on the database tables. Now in DCL we have two commands. First one is grant, that is used to provide any user access privileges or other privileges for the database. And the second one is revoke. It is used to take back permissions from any users. Now to allow user to create a particular session, and when we create a user in SQL, it is not even allowed to log in and create a session until and unless proper permissions or privileges are granted to the user. The following command can be used to grant the sessions, like grant create session to particular user name. Allowing a user to create table, the command will be like grant create table to username. This will allow user to create a table in the database. Now providing user with the space on table space to store the particular table. So allowing a user to create a table is not enough to start storing the data in that table. So we also must provide the user with privileges to use the available table space for their table and data. So command will be like alter user username quota unlimited on system. So above command will alter the user details and will provide it access to unlimited table space on the system. Make a note of that, generally unlimited quota is provided only for admin users. Now when I talk about granting all privileges to a user, say for example sysdba is a set of privileges which has all the permissions in it. So if you want to provide all the privileges to any user, we can simply grant them like sysdba permissions, and the query will be like grant sysdba to respective username. Now granting a permission to create a particular table or any table, so sometimes user is restricted from creating tables with names which are reserved for system tables, but we can grant the privileges to a user to create any table using below command. So command is like grant create any table to username. So that will grant the permission to create any table. Now granting permission to drop any table, at the title suggests you want to allow user to drop any table from the database. So that will grant this privilege by writing grant drop any table to username. And similarly, to take back these permissions, we can use the revoke command, like revoke create table from username. Now where the SQL clause is been where clause in SQL is been used, in case of like where clause is used to specify or apply any condition while retrieving, updating or deleting the data from a table. This clause is used mostly with select, update and delete query. When we specify a condition using the where clause, then the query executes only for those records where the condition is specified and it is satisfied. So if you check the syntax for where clause, it is very easy. You can use the where clause with a delete statement or any other statement. Say for example, delete from table name where the respective condition is given. So this clause at the end of any SQL query, to specify a condition for execution. For example, if you have a table student, which consists of student ID, name, age and address, and certain records are inserted to it. Now we will use the select statement to display the data of the table based on a condition which we will add to select query using where clause. So for example, if I write a simple query to display the record for student ID 101, so my query will be like this: select student ID, name, age and address, all the four columns, from student where SID is equals to 101. So this query will result into the record where my SID is 101, name Adam, age 15 and address will be Noida. Now if you are to apply these conditions on the text field, then in the same example we can have a condition like name, where we can specifically mention the name, right? Now operators for where clause conditions will be like this: equals to operator, then not equals to operator you can use, less than, greater than, less than or equals to, greater than or equals to, between a specified range of values, like operator is used to search for a particular pattern in a value, and in operator is for given set of values, right? Now next is our like clause in SQL. Like clause is used in the condition in SQL query with where clause. Now like clause compares data with an expression using wildcard operators, right, to match the particular pattern. Now these wildcard operators are like percentage sign and underscore sign. So there are two wildcard operators. The percentage sign is going to represent 0, 1 or more than one character. And underscore sign will represent only a single character. So for example of like clause, if you consider a table that is student, which consists of student ID, student name and age, have certain records. So if I write down the query like select star from student where student name like a percentage. So what this query denotes, that we will have the records of student table where the name starts with a. So the output of this query will be all three records will be displayed because student name starts with Adam, Alex and Abhi. So it satisfies that requirement of like clause. Now utilizing like clause using underscore and percentage sign. So if you check the first query, select star from student where my student name like underscore D percentage. So the above query will return all the records from student table where my student name contains D as a second character. Okay. Now using percentage sign only, select star from student where my student name like percentage X. So this query will return all the records from student table where my student name contain X as last character. So the position of that element is giving you the idea that which record will be fetched from the respective table. Now moving to the next point, that is order by clause. Now in SQL order by clause, it is used with select statement for arranging the retrieved data in sorted order. The order by clause by default sorts the retrieved data in ascending order by default. But to sort the data in descending order, we have to explicitly use the keyword, that is DESC, descending, in the with your order by clause. Now if you check the syntax of order by, it is like select column list from table name ordered by ASC or DES, ascending or descending. Now if you check this using the default order by statement, consider the following employee table, which consists of employee ID, name, age and salary. Now if I fire a query like select star from employee order by salary, so what it will do, this query will return the resultant data in ascending order of the salary, whatever is given. So I will get all the records with ascending order. If you see, there are same records with salary values that will also be utilized, and the same record whichever is present in the sequence. Say for example, 403 will be our first record in the output because the salary is 6000 and we are arranging it in ascending order by default. Second record will be 402 8000. Third record will be 405 8000. Fourth record will be 401 9000. and last record will be 404 employee ID and the salary will be 10,000. Okay, now using the order by clause for descending case. Now consider the same employee table in our previous slide that we have considered, and if I fire a query on that table, like select star from employee, order by salary is descending. So this query will return the resultant data in the descending order of the salary. Okay, now the SQL group by clause is used to group the results of a select query based on one or more columns. So it is also used with SQL functions as well to group the result from one or more tables. If you check the syntax, select column name function column name from particular table name where the condition is mentioned, group by a respective column name, right? So if you check the example of group by in a particular statement, then if you consider the table employee where employee ID, name, age and salary is given, and here we want to find name and age of the employees grouped by their salaries. So what will happen here, as a result we will get a particular data set with unique salary that has been listed. So we have two records for 9,000, we have two records for 8,000 and we have one record for 6,000. So after applying this group by considering the salary, then you will get only three records in your output table, which will consist of the salaries like 6,000, 9,000 and 8,000. Now group by is also used to group the different row of data together based on any one column. Say for example, select name age from employee group by salary. So when you apply this, the output will be like you will get the data of name and age, and which is applied according to the salary. So we have three records like 9,000, 6,000 and 8,000 from above case. So we will get the output like Rohan, that is having the age 34 because the salary is 6,000. Second record will be Shane with the age 29, the salary is 8,000. And third record will be Anu with the age 22 because the salary is 9,000. Okay, so in this way my group by clause is going to get work. Now if you check the example of group by in a statement using where clause. So combination of group by with where clause can be done. Consider the table employee again, employee ID, name, age and salary. The query that we will be firing will be like select name and salary from employee. So two columns that we are targeting, name and salary, where the age is greater than 25, group by salary. So already group by will be work, and the condition of age greater than 25 needs to be imposed on that group by case. So the output for this query will be like only three records, Rohan with salary 6,000 because age is 34, which is greater than 25. Then Shane with salary 8,000 because age is 29, and Scott with the salary 9,000 because the age is 44. Remaining records will not be considered because already the group by clause has been imposed. Now you must remember that group by clause will always come at the end of the SQL query, just like the order by clause. Now moving towards the next topic, that is having clause. SQL having clause is used with SQL queries to give more precise condition for a particular statement. It is used to mention the condition in group by based SQL queries, just like where clause, which is used with select query. So the syntax for having clause will be like this: select column name function column name from table name where a particular condition is given, group by a respective column name which is having the function of column name and the respective condition. So if you check the example for using having clause, if you consider the table cells which is given, the order ID, order name, previous balance and the name of the customer is given. Now if you want to find the customer whose previous balance sum is more than 3000, the summation of the previous balance more than 3000, that we have to find out. So the query will be like this: select star from sales, grouping by customer, so we are targeting the customer column, and which is having the condition like summation of previous balance is greater than 3000. So the output of this query will be only one record with order ID 11, order name will be ORD1, the previous balance will be 2000 and the name of the customer is Alex, because if you check in the table, Alex has two records, and if you check the sum of all the previous balances, that will be 4000 because the order ID 11 is having 2000 and order ID 15 is also having 2000, and that satisfies the condition of greater than 3000. So you will get the first row, that is Alex, as an output of this query. Now moving towards the next topic, that is keyword distinct. The distinct keyword is used with select statement to retrieve the unique values from the respective table. So the distinct will remove all the duplicate records while retrieving the records from any table in the database. If you check the syntax of distinct keyword, it is like select distinct name of the column from table name. For example, if you check, consider the following employee table. As you can see in the table below, there is employee name along with the salary and age. Now in this table, multiple employees have the same salary. So we will be using distinct keyword to list down the distinct salary amount that is currently being paid to the employees. So in employee ID, name, age and salary, you will check the record. And if I fire the query like select distinct salary from employee, the output of this query will be like only one column, which consists of the information about the salary, and the values will be like 5000, 8000 and 10000. Because we have total 5 records in the input table, but the output table will only consist of 3 records because of the distinct keyword. So 3 unique values of 5000, 8000 and 10000 will be considered, and the duplicate records of 8000 and 10000 are not considered using the distinct keyword. Now the operators. SQL has an AND and OR operators as well. These operators are used with the WHERE clause to making the condition more precise for fetching a particular data from the database, and by combining more than one conditions together. So if you come up with a situation where multiple conditions needs to be combined or either OR case is there, so in that case my AND and OR operator will be used. First go with the AND operator. AND operator is used to set the multiple conditions with the WHERE clause alongside, say you can use select, update or delete SQL queries as well. If you check the example for AND operator, we have a table called employee which consists of employee ID, name, age and salary. Now if I apply the query like select star from employee where my salary is less than 10,000 and age is greater than 25. So two respective conditions are joined, merged with the help of AND operator. Now this query will return the records where salary is less than 10,000 and simultaneously age is greater than 25. So hope you are getting this concept. So we have used the AND operator to specify the two conditions with WHERE clause. So the output of this query will be like two records like employee ID 402 with salary 8,000 because it satisfies the first condition that 8000 is less than 10,000 and age is 29, which is greater than 25. And the second record will be employee ID 405 Tiger, which consists of salary 9000 and age is 35, which also satisfies the condition. Now second is OR operator. The OR operator is also used to combine multiple conditions with WHERE clause. The only difference between AND and OR is their working behavior. When we use an AND to combine two or more than two conditions, it records satisfying all the specified conditions will be there in the result. Whereas in case of OR operator, at least one condition from the condition specified must be satisfied by any record to be in the final result. So if you check the example for OR operator, we have a table employee with parameters like employee ID, name, age and salary. And if I fire a query like select star from employee where my salary is greater than 10,000 or my age is greater than 25. So either or condition will be executed and the records which are satisfying this condition will be in our output. So we got four records, 402, 403, 404 and 405, because all of them are having age greater than 25. And only Shane is having and Tiger is having salary less than 10,000, but it is satisfying the condition of age. So that's why these four records will be there in the picture. Okay. Now the last topic, that is division operator. How the division operator works in SQL. The division operator is used when we have to evaluate the queries which contains the keyword all. Say, like, for example, which person has the account in all the banks of a particular city? So all is the keyword that has come. Another, like, which students have taken all the courses required to be graduate? So in this above specified problem statements, the description after the keyword all that will defines a set which contains some elements, and the final result will contain those units which satisfy these particular requirements. Another way is you can identify the usage of division operator is by using the logical implications of if and then. Say, like, for example, if there is a bank in that particular city, that person must have an account in that bank. Or second can be, if there is a course in the list of courses required to be graduated, that person must have taken that course, right? So now we'll see one by one how actually it works. So using division operator, we will find out the correct SQL query for getting the respective result for the first problem statement. So my query, the problem statement query will be like, find all the students who can graduate. It means all who have taken all the subjects which are required for one to get graduated. So directly we cannot come up to this. So we have to follow certain step. So first step is find all the students. So we will create a set of all students that have taken the courses with the help of command like create table all students. So one table will be created with the name all students, and we will have the query like as select distinct student name from course taken, right? So you will get a student names, those have taken the courses. Second step is finding all the students and the courses which are required to be graduated. So in this case, we will create a set of students and the courses they need to be graduate. So we can express this with the Cartesian products of all students and course required. So if you check the query, you will find that using create table students and required as select all students dot student name and course required dot course from all students and course required. So two tables simultaneously we are dealing with all students and course required. Now third step is finding all the students and the required courses they have not taken. So here we are taking our first step for finding the students who cannot graduate. That is our main query. Now the idea is very simple, that you have to find the students who have not taken the certain courses for required graduation. It means that they won't be able to be graduate. So we have to work on this query, that create table students and not taken as select star from student and required where it not exists. Which one? So the inner block will be select star from course taken where students and required dot student name is equals to course taken dot student name. And student and required dot course is equals to course taken course. So a combination of and as well as select is being done with respect to the where clause condition. The next step is finding all the students who cannot graduate. So all the students who are present in the above table, that is students and not taken, are the one who cannot graduate. So our query will be like this: create table cannot graduate at select distinct values from student name, and the table will be students and not taken. So you will get the results according to this query. And the last step is finding all the students who can graduate. So the query will be like this: create table can graduate at select from all students where it does not exist, select from cannot graduate, where the condition will be cannot graduate student name is equals to all students dot student name. Now after applying all these five steps, we can combine all these operations into single query, and this will be my final result to satisfy the problem statement. So the query will be like this: select distinct x dot student name from course taken as x where not exist, select star from course required as where not exist, select star from course taken as z where z dot student name equals to x dot student name and z dot course equals to y dot course. So this will give me a single student name according to the table that we have considered for example, and that will be the student who haven't taken the respective course. Okay, so I hope you have understood all the topics that I have explained in the basic part of SQL. Stay updated and subscribe the channel for coming videos. Thank you.